So in this question, it is given that in GS plane, there is OLTF is given by G of S is equal to pi e to the power minus G of S is given by pi e to the power minus 0.25 S upon S. This is an open loop transfer function. Now it says that in GS plane, the Nyquist plot passes through negative real axis at the point. So we have to find the point at which the Nyquist plot passes through negative real axis. So there are four options: minus 0.5 comma J0, minus 0.75 comma J0, minus 1.25 comma J0, and minus 1.5 comma J0. So this is question from GATE 2019 electrical branch. So first of all, G of S is given at like this. So at negative real axis, this is the positive real axis, this is the negative real axis. So here the angle is minus 90 degree, here angle is minus 180 degree, here angle is minus 270 degree, and here angle is minus 360 or 0 degree. So at negative real axis, this is the negative real axis. So at negative real axis, the angle is minus 180 degree. So at negative axis, the angle will be minus 180 degree. So we have to equate the angle to minus 180 degree. So angle of G of J omega is equal to, put S equal to J omega. So pi e to the power minus 0.25 minus J 0.25 omega upon omega. And we have to find its angle. So it should be equal to minus 180 degree. The angle should be equal to minus 180 degree. So angle of J omega will be equal to angle of pi plus angle of e to the power minus J 0.25 omega upon angle of J omega. So pi is a DC term, so its angle will be zero. And this is e to the power j theta, e to the power j theta. So angle is obviously theta. E to the power j theta. So whatever is with j is the theta. So its angle will be equal to, so I am writing here, and this should be equal to minus 180 degree. So the angle will be equal to, angle for pi is 0, angle for e to the power minus j 0.25 is minus 0.25 omega. And angle of J omega is pi by 2. And if it goes in the numerator, then it will become minus pi by 2. So it minus pi by 2. So this should be equal to minus 180 degree. Now omega is in radian. This is also in radian. This is in degree. So we have to convert it into radians. So 180 degree is equal to pi radians, and 90 degree is equal to pi by 2 radians. 45 degree is equal to pi by 4 radians. So remember this. So minus 0 point, or we can write it as minus of omega by 4 minus pi by 2 is equal to minus of pi. So if you solve it, you will get minus, if you take the LCM, then so minus of omega minus of 2 pi is equal to minus pi. So we will get minus of omega minus 2 pi is equal to minus of 4 pi. So omega will be equal to 2 pi. So we have got the omega is equal to 2 pi. So we have got the value of the frequency at which the of the negative at the negative real axis, when the Nyquist plot crosses the negative real axis. So we have got omega. So now we just have to find the magnitude at this frequency. So magnitude of G of J omega will be equal to magnitude of pi e to the power minus 0.25 J omega upon J omega. And magnitude of e to the power j theta, if we have a term e to the power j theta, it is cos theta plus j sin theta. So its magnitude is equal to magnitude of e to the power j theta is equal to under root of cos square theta plus sin square theta. and this will be equal to 1. Under root of, so magnitude of e to the power j theta is 1. So the magnitude of this term will be equal to 1. And magnitude of j is also 1. So the magnitude of j to the power j omega will be equal to pi upon omega. And omega we have already found out to be pi by 2. So we can substitute pi by 2 here. So pi upon pi by 2. Sorry, omega we have found out to be 2 pi. So we can substitute omega equal to 2 pi here. So the magnitude will be equal to 1 upon 2. And at negative real axis, the magnitude will be minus 0.5 because it is the negative real axis. So minus 1 by 2 or minus 0.5. So the correct option will be minus 0.5 and J0. Obviously, at the negative real axis, the imaginary part will be 0. And the real part will be with negative sign. So minus 0.5 comma J0. So this is the correct option. So please like and share this video and subscribe this channel. And if you have any doubt in this question or any other question or any other video of this channel, then you can comment in the comment box. So, and if you have any other doubt also, then also you can comment in the comment box. Also, if you want to share any feedback for this channel, then please leave the comment in the comment box. Because this is channel for students only. This is not my channel. This is channel for you. This channel is for just for students. This channel is for students only and for solving the doubts of the students. So please share your doubts. Please share your feedback in the comment box. Thank you and best of luck.